Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel Moira Diviner. Today I have with me Dinesh Mohan, Silver Fox of India. He's 61 years old and that's amazing. He's a supermodel, fashion icon, actor. You've seen him in movies like Bharat, Sankyak, Bar and Happy Sardar, and even a cute short film now. You've recently spoken for Economic Times, Conclave also, sir. So thank you for joining me today on my chat show.
You're most welcome. Most welcome.
Thank you. So please tell our viewers about yourself and your work.
Everything is now out there on social media. That's the power of social media. But still, for somebody who is watching for the first time, I'm an actor and a model. Of course, I'm a few months older than 61 years. And I started acting and modeling almost at the age of 57. I got the offer when I was 56 and I was turning 57 in a month. So the shoot happened when I had already turned 57. It's been a very nice journey. I've not had to make a lot of effort to make my name or a space or a place for myself in this line. This industry has been very kind to me and very welcoming, and it's given me a new lease of life. And so I'm absolutely enjoying this phase of life now as a model and an actor. It's a new identity though, but now I've got used to it. Yes.
That's really amazing and so inspiring for all us youngsters. You know, like we get lazy or tired, and then when we see you, it's really inspiring. And especially,
thank you so much for saying that. Thanks a lot.
When you're walking on the ramp and it feels so good, and all your pictures, it's awesome energy. What is your spiritual mantra or passion in life?
My spiritual mantra is, you know, as everybody knows by now, that I suffered a lot in my life. It was like a very rough time for me for a very, very long time, for almost, you know, a good part of my youth, my younger years. And when it, you know, at the peak of those things, I lost my job, I lost my family, and I lost the city that I used to call home. And many of the choices were made, these choices were made by me only, but they were under a lot of compulsion. You know, I could not see a way out of that situation without making a few major sacrifices in my life. So I chose to make those sacrifices and, you know, wait for that time to pass. But then I slipped into depression and, you know, a lot of medical issues and a lot of disabilities kicked in. And a lot of, you know, I had a very rough time. So when I came out of it, helped by the doctors, of course, and my own effort and my support system, I realized only one thing, rather two things, yes. The first one that I realized was that self-love is the best kind of love that you can have in this world, you know, not in a narcissistic or selfish manner, but in a very forgiving kind of manner towards yourself. You have to forgive yourself first. You don't have to carry any negative baggage of your past or any regrets, you know, for you to move creatively and constructively into the future. So I decided that above all relationships, I have to keep my relationship with myself as the first priority. And I decided I will not let anybody affect my peace from now onwards. So my life started improving. You know, I was respecting myself, I was loving myself, and that showed on my face and in my aura, and then people would give me the same reaction. And then the second, you know, conclusion that I drew was that you should always live every moment to the fullest. So I went ahead and did the first youngish action of my life at the age of almost 55 when I had recovered, and got this tattoo done, which says live life to its fullest.
Wow.
So then it reminds me every day that I don't have to lose any more time in, you know, being joyful. I won't say happy or sad, because both these are temporary, but joyful, you know, which lasts. So
beautiful, beautiful learning, sir. Beautiful messages. And that is so true. Even if, like, you know, I've spoken to all the psychic mediums now, and they pass on the same message from the spirit world, that you should love yourself. That should come at the topmost. Beautiful message. But this, you know, coronavirus situation has left a lot of people lonely. And how are you coping with it?
Yes, because my life also underwent a few major changes. You know, I recently shifted home, and we started off here in this new home with my family, my sister and brother-in-law, and my bhanja. But then all of a sudden, due to the infection growing here and some changes in their work life, I had to send them off out of Delhi to a safer place. Mm-hmm. And then that is how the loneliness started kicking in my case, you know. Yeah. So, but then I realized that, okay, I can learn new things. I can new arts. So like today, for lunch, I was, you know, recollecting my days of shoot in Thailand. And there I tried many new dishes, of course, vegetarian, because I'm a pure vegetarian. So I decided to make sticky rice with mango chutney.
Wow.
So, you know, these are ways to kill your loneliness, that you keep yourself busy. And I do my meditation, I do my exercise, workout. And I decided that I have to come out of this looking fitter and healthier mentally and physically. So that is how I keep myself positive.
Great, great. And if, you know, given one chance or one power to you for one day, what would you like to change and how?
I would like this COVID thing or any other, you know, viruses that are there waiting, lurking somewhere, all to vanish. And of course, then, you know, I would rather say one more thing, which is more encompassing. I would like every citizen of this world to be happy. So happiness, you know, includes your health, your wealth, your career, your kids, your family.
Yeah.
So it's that. So everybody should be happy. Yes.
True. That should be the real purpose. And I feel changes in our work, lifestyle, everywhere in any institution is required. And that should focus from government side also to how it can be made a part of life. Happiness.
Correct. And you know, what I have learned in life is, you know, I look at every situation from very different angle. Like in school or college, when we could not pass a certain test, so, you know, the teacher would give us a lot of, say, I won't say punishments, but homework, more homework and things like that. So this time that we are passing through is more homework given to us by the Creator. Because we've been abusing Mother Planet so much, you know. We've been bahut gande bachche, gande students banke hum rahe hain yahan pe ab tak. So these are lessons we have to learn. And I hope ke hum sab isme se bahar nikle as better citizens, better human beings, and we respect all life, living or non-living, vegetation or animals or birds or fish or whatever. And we treat everybody with love. So that is, I hope we learn that.
True, true, sir. Very well said. So what about your upcoming work and online activities?
Online, I've been, you know, social media is trending like hell these days because everybody is there on. So I've been busier and busier doing lives and Zooms and, you know, conferences. And not only in India, the UK people have covered me, Australian people have covered me, Canadian people have covered me. It's a crazy ride. I didn't expect that I would become this international, you know, trending person.
You are an inspiration, sir. You are.
Yeah. I don't know about that. But the thing is that that keeps me busy. Plus, I've been doing a lot of home shoots because people have been sending me a lot of products at home, and that is a new trend. Or even TV commercials, you know, but they ask us to shoot ourselves. Now things are opening up a little bit, shoots are happening again. But till now, I was shooting at home only, and I've done a lot of shoots at home for different products. So this is what keeps me busy. Plus, I've finished shooting for a Malayalam movie and a Tamil movie. So as soon as this situation is better, they'll be releasing.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Do we get to know the name?
Yes. Yes, of course. The Malayalam movie is called Anna Pramble World Cup. The Malayalam name is a little difficult, so I've used the convenient name that is there in my mind. It basically means World Cup in an elephant field. So it's a true story of a team in Kerala of young boys who, by force took over a piece of land, converted into a football field, and went on to win the World Cup. I guess in early 80s. And that football field and that field belongs to a person that is me, who's a Muslim character and who wants to throw them out of that,
So it's a
negative character.
But that will be so much challenging role. Yeah, nice.
Yeah, it was because I'm this greedy, grabbing kind of person who's just accumulating wealth and not even giving it to the kids and all that.
Waiting for that to release.
Yeah. And the next movie is called Colors of Life. It's a Tamil movie and my role is even more shocking in that because I play a rapist. Yeah, I'm such an innocent looking boy. I don't know why I'm given these roles.
I think that'll bring in more of the acting because your features are so well. They'll match with
people. Yes. Yeah, so as an artist, I feel so challenged and I love that these different things are coming my way and people think that I'm not this crying grandfather, Mala japta hua jo ek kone mein baitha hai. And sabko keh raha bhagwan bhala kare and all that. Good. On screen villainy is much more lasting than good actors.
Yeah. What about your hobbies, sir?
Hobbies, I like to read a lot and lots of books on spirituality because when I was passing through my bad phase, some nice soul suggested that why don't you read books on spirituality and that will open up the knots in your brain and the questions that you have. So I have a library of more than 3,000 spiritual books I love to read and reread them all the time. And that is my biggest hobby, reading. Yep. And I write also at times.
I'm planning to... No, not at all.
As a model and actor, people expect that you go to parties and you drink and smoke. And I'm sorry, I do none of that. Mm. I would rather sit at home with my books and read and enrich my knowledge than go and, just waste my time.
Best thing to do, sir. Yeah. Yes. Coming up to my rapid fire section, favorites? So, favorite attire or outfit?
Is my phata hua jeans and any gandhi si t-shirt.
Comfort comes first. Favorite food?
Favorite food is of course oats made in a very healthy manner and I've shown the recipe also on Times Network. So I've cooked there, so that is my favorite food.
Wow. Favorite color?
Favorite color is black, white and blue and gray. Mm-hmm. Gray. So these colors are my favorite.
Black, I definitely agree. I've seen so many of your white and black and even blue outfits.
Yes.
Look really good on you. And favorite actor and actress?
Favorite actor is, not as much as the cinematic, expertise. But my favorite actor is Akshay Kumar because of his lifestyle, because he's a fitness freak and he does a lot of social work and, inside story we don't know and I don't care. What is shown on social media, I trust to believe that. So his image is, as per me, very holistic. And my favorite actress is, of course, the tigress, the lioness, Kangana Ranaut. Again, for her lifestyle.
Yeah, both my favorites. Wow.
Yes.
And any message for youngsters, sir?
Yeah, yes. Anytime, though I'm not that preachy kind of person who would sit and sermonize and everybody would say, hey, Buddha, toh hamesha apna salah hi deta rehta. I'm not like that. So my advice to youngsters is go out and live it to the fullest. Have a lot of fun, but within safe limits. So that is what my
wonderful
message is.
Yeah. Just one last question, sir. So for working in this industry, what do you suggest to them, and some health tips if there are any?
Sorry, can you repeat that?
Working in the media industry, what do you suggest, and some health tips?
Yes, yeah, of course. See, it's not only connected with the media. These days, being fit is good for any profession you are in, or even if you are sitting at home. So you have to eat right, you have to work out right, and if you are fit, then you always look better than people who are not fit. So, and this media line has got pressures that you just cannot foresee. You know, it's highly competitive, it's highly cutthroat, and every day a new crop of actors and models is descending on the scene. So you have to, you know, mentally and physically be very strong to face all the competition that is entering the industry every day. So be strong.
Wow, yeah, valuable suggestion, sir. Thank you so much for being here today on my chat show. Lovely catching up with you.
You're most welcome, and God bless you. Be safe.
Thank you, sir. Take care. Bye.
Bye.